Enjoy the convenience of 7 days a week banking and extended hours with Cube from First Arkansas Bank and Trust, member FDIC. From the Eat My Catfish studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show. It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Hour number two at Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer standing by. In Northwest Arkansas, I'm Randy Rainwater from Central Arkansas.
Ray Tucker on Drive Time Sports is brought to you by Guatney Buick GMC. Now to Trey Betty, brought to you by Asher Wrecker Service, 501-562-2293. Family owned and operated since 1980. Asher Wrecker, dependable towing and vehicle recovery service. Ask for Asher.
Good afternoon, Trey.
Hey, guys.
You were around for this commitment today.
Yeah, I didn't miss this one, and he's a nice one. Tyrus Washington, 6'4", 230-pound tight end out of Leesburg, Georgia. He's the seventh commitment that Sam Pittman has got out of the state of Georgia since he's been here. And just to put it in perspective, and Danny did this for me earlier, but the last five recruiting classes before him there were five players total from the state of Georgia. So they've definitely put in a lot of work in that state, and it has really paid off. And, you know, this is a guy that had plenty of options. He's number 561 overall prospect in the country, had offers from Cincinnati, Boston College, Georgia Tech, Kansas State, Maryland, Nebraska, NC State, Ole Miss, Pitt, Tennessee, South Carolina, Wisconsin, Vanderbilt. Had a lot of options out there, and, he's been a guy that Arkansas has pursued for a long time. It seems like I think Danny West has had a crystal ball projection into him to end up at Arkansas since April. So he's a guy that's kind of been on the radar for some time now. And it gives Arkansas two tight ends for the class, and that's an area of need. I mean, they are thin at that position. They brought in just one last year in Aaron Outley, and, I mean, they really just have two – tight ends that are proven, and you know Hudson's been injured a lot. They need him to stay healthy and have a big year this year. But Blake Kern will be gone after this season, so they definitely needed some tight ends, and they've got two with him and Dax Courtney now.
We know what kind of a relationship builder Sam Pittman is, and having been at the University of Georgia, he touched so many high school coaches and won those guys over, and it continues to feed him now.
Absolutely. I don't think there's any question. And you know, Cody Kennedy is the offensive line coach now, but when they started the recruitment of Tyrus Washington, he was the tight ends coach. And he also has some experience in Georgia and dealing with high school coaches there. And, you know, we can't underestimate the value of Jimmy Smith that he's been. I mean, just think about how many kids came for that first camp from Cedar Grove, Georgia. And there's some guys that they really like. I mean, there's some big-time players on that team. And he used to be, you know, the head coach there, so he's got a lot of ties in that regard. And already has one commitment from Georgia, and Rashad DeBinion at running back. So, yeah, the ties in Georgia have been strong. Now, Texas has been a little interesting. I mean, you know, not in past classes, but this class currently, what are there, 15 commitments? He's number 15 right now. There's not a single commitment from the state of Texas on this list, and that's a very different approach than we saw with Chad Morris, which is something that I never gave Chad Morris a hard time about their recruiting, because they really stepped it up in that department. But just a little bit of a different philosophy, I guess, going to where your strengths are. I would like to see them, you know, make sure that they get some guys out of Texas. I think maybe Jordan Crook, a linebacker out of there, is probably the best shot that they have in terms of getting a guy out of Texas. But it could be a little thin this year in that state. But they've certainly more than made up for it in the state of Georgia. And, I mean, they've been kind of all over the place. I mean, they've been in Tennessee. They've gotten some commitments, and, you know, Oklahoma, Louisiana, you know, up in Wisconsin, Michigan, and also Ohio, even Ohio. So they've been all over the place.
Trey, you mentioned this is the 15th verbal commitment. Is the magic number 25, or is there a number?
Yeah, well, I don't know that they'll take 25 straight out of the high school class, but just based on, you know, last year, I don't see where they can – I don't know where they could borrow from the past class. Now, they can work out something, I guess, where they could figure it out, because I guess you can – you know, kind of borrow to infinity. But, I think that they'll probably end up leaving, you know, at least I think it's probably in this day and age, it's a good idea to leave about three spots open because you can find immediate help these days in the transfer portal.
That's kind of similar to the position that Eric Musselman is finding himself in. This 2022 in-state class is so loaded. But yet the national interest, Barry Dunning, we talked about that, out of the state of Alabama, the Gatorade Player of the Year, who Auburn and Alabama certainly wanted to add to their roster. Jordan Walsh, who ultimately is a Texas kid, but is going to end up being a California kid if he goes ahead and follows through on his choice. As we're seeing several players do, going to one of the academies out in California. But and there are several others that seem to be high on Arkansas. So basketball, you know, I don't know if you can baller forward on basketball, but golly, there's so many good ones. You hate to see Khalil Ware inside the state, Darian Ford, Nick Smith. I mean, the list Nick just Smith. Goes on and on. Just not enough spots right now.
Yeah, we'll see how things shake out. I mean, with basketball, you could lose your entire roster. I mean, we've come pretty close to seeing it before. Musselman's, I guess, after his first year, the way they have two guys back last year, and Ethan Henderson and Desi Seals. I mean, you can need to replace almost an entire roster. So who knows? Maybe there will be room
to get them all. And of having almost an all-freshman team next year, that would be unique into itself. Let's talk with Patrick.
Especially for Musselman.
Yeah. Patrick, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Good afternoon, guys. Hey, Trey, long-time subscriber for Hog Sports. Great site.
Thank you.
I was looking at it today, and I didn't get the chance to complete my search, so I was hoping you might be able to help me out on this information, if it's even on. I mean, I'm sure it's on there somewhere. Kevin O'Bannon from ORU that we're going after for the basketball team. I'm just wondering what if there is a crystal ball, which I'm not asking for you to give it out, but that way I can search for that for sure. And also, what do you think as far as is he somebody that we are serious that we would take right now? And do you think we have any shots at him? Thank you, gentlemen. Y'all have a great day.
Thank you, Patrick.
Yeah, definitely more Curtis Wilkerson's territory, but I will say that it does look like there's interest. I mean, this Arkansas fan should remember him. He averaged 18.7 points, 9.6 rebounds for ORU last year. It's O'Banner, not O'Bannon, but O'Banner. And, 6'8", 225, that's been really the one thing. Like, you see all these preseason top 25 rankings. I've seen Arkansas recently as high as number 8 on CBS Sports. ESPN had him 13. These are just, you know, way too early polls that came out just this past week. But you'll see one of the main knocks is, you know, what about rebounding? And, you know, they've helped themselves in that area to a degree. But, I mean, this guy pulled down 9.6 rebounds last year. I mean, I would think that that would be a fantastic addition if they would be able to get him. And they've got a spot for him, so.
There has not been any indication, at least I've seen, that O'Banner has any favorites. Right now he's taking NBA trips, Cleveland being one that he took. I think he was there yesterday, Cleveland. But today I think, Trey, is the day that if you are having your name in the NBA draft, after today, if you hadn't pulled it out, then you've foregone your remainder of college eligibility. So he's got to make up his mind today, one way or the other, whether or not he goes or he stays in college.
Yeah, well, we'll find out a lot today then, I guess. Yeah. So, but yeah, I would imagine there wouldn't be many schools that wouldn't be interested in adding him to their roster.
Oh, his list is those that have contacted him is as long as most of our arms. I mean, it's a very impressive offer list, to say the least. You were extremely busy last week, in spite of the fact that you took time off. As an example, let me get to the pile that I've printed off. Let's see. Should have had this organized.
It's top 10 season.
Yeah. Top 10 Razorbacks who must step up in 2021. Then you had another one. Best bets to attend SEC Media Days from Arkansas. Then ranking redo. Arkansas Razorback football starters. My favorite, 2021 Arkansas football midseason projected depth chart. Do you realize how hard it was last week for me not to talk about this with you not being on the show?
Yeah, and it's four deep too. Yeah, it's that type of year. It's that time of year. I'm actually doing a series of stories right now, Randy, with going back and reevaluating Arkansas's past recruiting classes. Started in 2016. That group is almost everybody's done. There's still, you know, T.J. Hammonds and Deion Edwards are still with the program, who are, you know, using their 6 year of eligibility. But everybody's done. And Grant Morgan was a walk on in that class, actually. But just going back and, you know, looking at where the guys were ranked, seeing if they were undervalued or overvalued, and how the class was as a whole. And I got to tell you, for 2016, 2017, it's not pretty. 2018 is actually working on that one, finishing up that right now. But 2017 story will be out tomorrow morning. 2018, maybe might put that out tomorrow afternoon. We'll see just how far along I get on it. But yeah, just at that kind of year. You know, you mentioned the SEC Media Days. We should be finding that out in not too much longer. I mean, we're coming up on it pretty quick here. So we'll find out on that. And, you know, there's two schools of thoughts with who you bring to SEC Media Days. Some coaches like to bring only seniors. We saw that, of course, with Brett Bielema. Some coaches just like to bring their best players. I think that's the best way to do it. I get – you know, wanting to reward your seniors, reward them some other way. We want to talk to the best player, not your senior offensive lineman and stuff. I'm just saying, like, from a national publicity standpoint, that doesn't do much for you. So take Treylon Burks, take Grant Morgan, take Jalen Catalon. Those are three all-SEC level players and would all do well. And I'm not a big fan of also taking a quarterback before he has a chance to start. It seems like any coach who does that, it sometimes feels a little gimmicky, but it always feels like the quarterback busts, like they don't live up to their expectation, you know. So to me, you know, take your top three returning guys regardless of classification, and Pittman may have a different philosophy, and that's fine. I'm just saying, from a media standpoint, what fans want to see and, you know, what people are going to be attracted to is, you know, seeing guys that are accomplished and are the best players on your team, not guys that are just, you know, good players that have seniors that have done everything the right way. And those guys should be rewarded and commended. But to me, find a different way.
And especially coming off a COVID year when your players have not had as much exposure as they normally do. If you got guys that have a chance to make the all teams, and Catalan's just a sophomore, you got to take them, because this is their chance. This is their chance to be in front of a lot of media, and it's interesting that that's a week and a half away, and they still haven't made that announcement yet.
Yeah, and I guarantee you too, Rick, that it increases your odds, because we'll come out. You know, we'll get our ballots for picking preseason all SEC teams.
Yeah, that's right.
And I guarantee you, it makes a difference in the minds of voters when they see a familiar name on there, because they just interviewed them. And it's,
exactly,
you know, people
right
from all over the SEC that are going to be there.
That's exactly right.
And they can make a really nice impression on those guys. And
yes,
and down the road, it pays off again.
Well, yep. And let's face it, Arkansas won 3 games last year, and everybody here was celebrating because that was after 0 wins for 2 years. But I don't know what an impression that made around the rest of the league. And so, therefore, you do need to take your best players there and let them get some exposure.
I'm sure you got the same notification, Trey, from the SEC talking about media days. It sounds like it's going to be scaled down. I know that Radio Row is going to be scaled down. And they talked about the main media room. It's going to be scaled down. Mm-hmm. And the electronic room, I mean, they go on and on. So they are talking COVID-19 restrictions.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder, again, you have it easy. No, I shouldn't say easy, but there's separation, easy separation from the podium that's in the main media room as compared it is to the breakout rooms.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm curious what they're going to do in the breakout rooms. Are they going to have this 6 feet or more apart from any of the speakers? I mean, I realize that's, who cares to those out there listening, but for us, it makes a difference of doing our job.
Yeah. Well, I mean, those out there listening, I mean, I think, you know, I don't know. I assume people understand that, you know, people are, you know, getting their information through our camera lens or through our microphone,
right,
or, you know, those things. The job that we're able to do, you know, relates to the quality of the content that they receive on the other end. So it is important, but I guess it's to be determined. I mean, I usually get a marker out and I see, you know, because for those who don't know how SEC Media Days work, there's 6 different rooms that they go in. You know, there's like a room dedicated for CBS, a room dedicated for ESPN, a electronic media room, a, you know, big media, you know, television room. So there's all these different spots that the players and coaches are assigned to go through. So it's just kind of like a carousel, a county fair, if you will, of going through different events. And we have, I guess, probably 3 rooms general media has access to. Would that be right, Randy?
Yeah.
3 rooms. And so what I would always do is figure out how I can orchestrate it where I can get in every room with every Arkansas representative. And so I'm, you know, running around, you know, with my hair on fire, getting cameras set up, going to each room because I want to get every bit of it while I'm there. So I don't believe I'm going to be able to do that this year based on how they've explained things about not being able to follow coaches from one room to the next and, you know, not being able to set up your own camera. I believe I'll be able to pull enough content, but I'm not going to be able, apparently, to do things the way I normally do it. Plus, we, you know, usually have, you know, a breakout, you know, opportunity, local media with, you know, the head coach and players, you know, up in the suite, either before or after everything gets going. I think that's usually before everything gets going. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know if we'll be able to do that either.
I hadn't even thought about that, but I would have doubts that they'll have the breakouts like that this
probably so
year. I would not. And I go back to, what's the media day going to be like?
Mm-hmm.
Are they going to grant us face-to-face access with these kids, or is it going to be back to the Zoom approach?
Surely not.
I know. Like, in the big media room, I mean, it's, you know, you're pretty much just, it's a bunch of reporters crowding around a table with the players on, you know, each corner of the room. So are they going to put them behind glass? I don't know how they're going to do it. But that's one reason I'm not going for the whole thing this year, just because of, I'm a little concerned about how they're going to handle everything. And then Arkansas also is on the back, you know, the last day. I can't remember when Arkansas has been the last day, but that is also a day, Randy, you know, it might be beneficial for us in our coverage of it, just because a lot of people start, you know, heading out, you know, they start ducking out that last day, even though there's, you know, what, 3 coaches, 3 schools remaining. A lot of people, you know, end up ducking out. They've been there the whole time. And, you know, SEC does it longer than anybody. I don't know if you guys have seen the schedule for, you know, Big 12, ACC, all these other conferences, but they're two-day events. This is a – SEC does a four-day event. You know, it's just one more reason that the SEC is the greatest conference in the country. Do everything twice as hard.
Oh, it's a ghost town. We've talked about this multiple times on Radio Row, and that's when they allowed capacity to extend. It is probably, when you say, at least 150-foot hallway, and then it spills out into a little bit of a foyer, and then I think even 2019, 18, it actually spilled into the actual walkway into the different businesses into that center area.
Oh, so. Over into the mall area.
Yeah.
For those who don't know, it's at the Winfrey Hotel Hyatt Regency in Hoover, Alabama. And, you know, it's got a decent setup for, you know, the ballroom area and all this stuff to accommodate and everything. But also in there, it's attached to a pretty large mall in addition.
Extremely large.
It's like you have to, like, I've been there a couple of days and have thought, like, I haven't been outside because I just, you know, went to the food court to eat, you know, and been conducting interviews and then, you know, downstairs and then go up to my hotel room. And I'm just like, have I been outside today? So you got to kind of remind yourself, step outside and get some fresh air every once in a while. But it's right around the corner. Time to start talking football for real.
Okay. That's Trey Biddy of HogSports.com. Trey, we'll talk with you tomorrow. Being brought to you by Asher Wrecker Service Company. Rick Schaefer, Ray Tucker, I'm Randy Rainwater. Drive Time Sports will continue in a moment.
The Great Arkansas Beer Festival and the Rock City Margarita Festival had combined this year for the biggest party of the summer. Presented by 103.7 The Buzz and Oaklawn Racing Casino Resort.
The used car market is absolutely on fire right now, and Guadagni Butte GMC in North Little Rock is leading the pack. However, Guadagni has taken a unique approach during the month of June by helping you get retail for your own car. Maybe you have a car to sell and you don't want to settle for the average trade-in value when going by the book. Guadagni Butte GMC can help you beat that by marketing and selling the vehicle for you. Give Guadagni Butte GMC a call. Let Guadagni do the hard work while you get retail for the vehicle you're wanting to sell. Guadagni Butte GMC is offering to market and sell your current vehicle while getting retail. Zero hassle on your part. No photo taking, no posting online, no answering messages. An effortless way to sell your current vehicle at the numbers used cars are commanding today. A safe way to sell. No meeting Craigslist strangers in dark parking lots to try and sell your vehicle. Call Guadagni Buick GMC at 945-4444. GuadagniBuickGMC.com. GMC. We are professional grade.
Brought to you by Bowrider and their industry-leading 3-year, 36,000-mile limited warranty. Includes spark plugs, starter, battery, alternator, and more. Bowrider, now open in Russellville, Conway, North Little Rock, and Bryan.
This is Pat Bradley for Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union in Benton in their Saline County Summer Auto Loan Special. Right now, you can get interest rates as low as 1%. That's 1%. Take the summer off with no payments for 90 days or how about 84 months financing. Offer valid on new 20 or 21 models, or you can refinance your current auto loan. Go to alcoacommunityfcu.org and apply securely online today. Member owned, member focused, Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union in Benton.
For more than two decades, Reed's Metals has been providing metal roofing, steel buildings, and all the accessories for customers to buy direct and save. Reed's Metals specializes in on-job, sight-standing seam in over 20 colors, plus 26 and 29 gauge AZ-50 and AZ-55 Galvalume, backed by a 45-year written paint warranty and a 25-year warranty on acrylic-coated Galvalume. Buy direct and save at Reed's Metals, located I-30 South in Benton. 501-776-3825. Online at reedsmetals.com.
Arkansas Travelers Baseball is back. Take your family out to the ball game at Dickie Stevens Park for a safe summer of family affordable fun. Weekly theme nights include Wednesdays, Dollar Dog Days of Summer, Thirsty Thursdays, Firework Fridays, giveaways every Saturday, and Family Sundays. Take me out for Arkansas Travelers Baseball. Visit Travs.com for tickets. Go Travs!
If you are not listening to From the Shortgrass, you have been missing this.
Coach Broyles, yeah, I noticed you took Steve Spurrier, Tommy Tuberville, and some of these coaches to Augusta, and I was wondering if there's any way I can go down there and play with you one time. Houston, I don't want you playing golf right now.
From the Shortgrass airs right here on 103.7 The Buzz every Friday morning from 5:30 to 6. Brought to you by Blackman Auctions and MinnowsPlus.com.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports, live from the Eat My Catfish studios. Feed your crave today at any of the five Eat My Catfish locations: Conway, Benton, Little Rock, North Little Rock, and now in Fayetteville. Contact them at eatmycatfish.com. Often imitated but never duplicated, this is Drive Time Sports with Randy Rainwater on the Buzz Radio Network.
Drive Time Sports in the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, Ray Tucker, I'm Randy Rainwater. Let's check in with Boss Hogg. Boss Hogg, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. How y'all doing?
Doing great. How about you?
Doing great, especially when I hear about how good we're doing on the recruiting trail, Randy. That's good stuff. You know, as we know from listening to our head hog, he only goes after the guys, and he doesn't have to give him a scholarship he doesn't want to, because he's only going to give scholarships to the ones he believes that are going to be the best, regardless of ranking. So the fact that we're, like, the last guy, the tight end out of Lees County, he sounds like he's going to be a ball player, you know, as well. It's very exciting there. What's your take on the recruiting trail?
The first question, Boss Hogg, when I get a chance to talk to the head coach, did you fill your needs? And I think Trey Biddy hit that best a few moments ago when talking about Tyverse Washington. He's the tight end. He fits the need because they're thin at that particular position. Arkansas is not recruiting a quarterback. Why? They're in good shape there right now. So that's not an immediate need. And what I like about this class, they certainly need more. That is offensive linemen, but they're off to a good start. I think the next area of concern, and they seem to be doing a good job there, that is in the defensive line, defensive ends in particular, but they need some big guys on the interior. And I know Trey talked about this yesterday, but you can't ever, it seems like, have enough linebackers, and especially with this class being so loaded with the current class of having so many seniors at that position. So I think they're filling needs. As long as you continue to feel needs, you got to feel good, and I'm with you. Sam Pittman does not seem to be the kind of coach who's going to just give a scholarship for the sake of giving a scholarship. He didn't seem to reach much from any players. Now, granted, there could be at times some other circumstances that may be issues to raise question marks if you actually would go ahead and recruit a youngster, but so far, we haven't seen that actually to be an issue.
Yeah, he's doing a really good job. I mean, you know, a really, really good job. An extraordinary job, I should say. So, exciting times. We've got to be too deep at every position, as you know. It's not even deeper than that, but we'll take too deep. Because, you know, as we talked last year, we were always solid as far as, like, if nobody got hurt. But, you know what I mean? We're in the SEC, which is the miniature NFL. You know what I mean? The minor leagues NFL. So, people are going to get hurt. But as soon as we, you know, sew up that too deep roster, you know what I mean, not too much of a gap, really not in gaps at all, and we'll be in good shape there. I do have a bone to pick with you, Randy. I know.
Okay.
I love Bobby Portis. I'm a Razorback fan through and through and through. But Chris Paul is going to be one of the best point guards in the history of the NBA.
No doubt about it.
And that's who I'm pulling for. It has nothing to do with not being a Razorback fan. I'm a huge Razorback fan. And I love me some Bobby Portis. But Bobby Portis has years left to play to get him a ring, you know. But, you know, this is Chris Paul's time. And, I hope, and obviously it's Bobby's time to go to the finals. But I'm just saying, like, I would like to see Chris Paul
who I believe is deserving of one and is a good, I believe he's a pretty good guy as well. So that's who I'm pulling for. I've heard a lot of beef back and forth, even on the morning shows and the other, you know what I mean? And people being told here and told that we recline, you know what I mean? And, you know, obviously Justin saying, you know, Bobby pulling this, maybe West, but at the same time, Milwaukee. But I just got to go the Hall of Famer, you know what I mean? He's too good to not have a ring, Randy.
No,
Boss
no.
Hogg, I got to pick about with you. You're not staying loyal to Arkansas.
Oh, come on.
You know,
Randy, you didn't say that to me, Randy, when I had the same sentiments he did just earlier in the show.
Hey, Randy, well, Ray knows what's up. Yeah,
I'm trying to be nice to Ray.
When Dallas Keuchel pitches against the Yankees, do you pull for him to win?
Oh, he does well. I didn't use the word win there.
Whoa,
I hope he does well.
Thanks, Rick.
Y'all have a good one, man. Y'all be safe.
Thank you.
Oh, you know, well.
The Yankees are coming to Kansas City soon. Do you pull for Andrew Benintendi to get the game-winning home run against them?
No. I pull for him
to
do well.
Well, don't chew on him for not pulling for the Bucks to beat the Suns.
No,
it's
Bobby,
okay.
he if he had said, I want Bobby Portis to do really, really well.
Yeah, that's fine.
But I just want Chris Paul to win. I might have felt differently, but I think, you know, the way he said it. Picking a bone with me.
I don't know what Bobby Portis's contract situation is, but he is due a hefty raise.
Helping himself.
He sure is. And when's he averaging 14 a game in the playoffs?
I think if nothing else, Raymond, he gets years, which Bobby hasn't gotten lately. He's kind of bounced around. He went to the Knicks, Bulls, Knicks, and now to Milwaukee.
But explain this to me. I'm watching the game last night. Chris Paul, who is a great point guard and can dissect a defense in a hurry. They're playing Bobby Portis man-to-man on Chris Paul above the circle, thinking that he can guard him and cut him off. Are
stupid.
You kidding me? It was about four possessions in a row. He just chewed him up and spit him out. What's that all about?
Well, even Van Gundy was, I mean, rightfully so. That was stupid on their part. To try to think that they could put Bobby Portis, who's what, 6'10"?
Yeah.
6'11"? He may be a great defender, but not against a guy with the quickness of a Chris Paul. And as you mentioned, what makes him lethal is that mid-range jumper where he can drive in the lane, stop, pop, and
that's his bread and butter.
Yeah, he is very lethal in that regards. All right, from our Asher Record Service Company Life in Feedback, Ben says, for Ray, I am a ULR season ticket holder. I have nothing about the new men's team players. When Joe Foley gets a transfer or signee, we get notification to read about it in the paper. Zero news of men signees. Why is that?
I think that's Darrell Walker's approach. He and I have visited a little bit about it, and anyway, that's the way Darrell handles his business.
Enough said there, I guess.
Yeah. I didn't agree with him, but, hey, I'm not the coach.
Also from our Asher Record Service Company, Life in Feedback, Mike says, reason we're going to have Zoom meetings and behind glass, et cetera, is because so many people out there won't listen to common sense and science and get their vaccine. Now, Mike, I know that isn't exactly how you wrote it, but I don't think it'd be quite as effective if I read it the way you wrote it. Hopefully, again, people will get their vaccines. And it'd be nice, again, for us to be able to interview these coaches and players more face-to-face than either through Zoom or otherwise.
Well, here's what's missing in the whole setup now. And we, you and Rick and I have been doing this a long time, and Rick lined up interviews for many, many years. When somebody sees somebody on television and somebody interviews them, they leave a lasting impression. If they're a very good speaker, if they're polished or whatever, if they're every other word, you try to teach them better. And the way you get better is through reps. And the more you're interviewed, the more you learn about the whole process, and the better you get and the better impression you make. And they've pretty much taken that away.
Can't argue that. I mean, to be able to look, I mean, there's so many stories behind the story.
Let me use this example, okay? Let's use our good friend Sidney Moncrief. I remember the first couple of times I interviewed Sidney Moncrief when I was at Channel 7. Sidney Moncrief was not a very good speaker. Sidney Moncrief now is one of the best speakers in the country, and he's a motivational speaker. But he got better and better and better, and by the time he was a junior, he was super.
He was good.
But he did that because he learned, and he got reps. Let him learn. And guess what? If you're going to do that, have somebody on your staff that teaches a class to these guys, or a segment, that says, here are the do's and don'ts in doing an interview. Don't let somebody try to trap you and keep asking you the same question. Just say, I have no response. And don't get trapped into it, because guys have an angle they want to take, and they'll try to take you down that road even though you don't want to go down that road.
I was going to say, one of the better, and I realize at times it seemed like Bob Holt asked 10,000 questions, not one or two questions, but he's good at trying to find a story to tell about that individual. And that's been taken away from Bob.
Yeah.
As you could tell at times on some of the Zoom press conferences, he will say after two or three questions, well, I've got some more questions, but I'll let somebody else ask some questions. And more often than not, it doesn't come back around to Bob. So he's not able to develop his story. And I just think that's one of the things we're missing by not being able. And the other part of it is only a few are they having on the Zoom, not where the entire locker room as it is on media day, where typically Rick and I would divide up the locker room. We wouldn't obviously interview every player in the locker room, but we did have access to them if we chose to.
That's right.
And you don't have that option right now. Let's talk to Ken. Ken, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, guys. I have a baseball question, sort of a hypothetical situation. Suppose that a team has a shortstop that's just a super good glove man, but he doesn't hit a lick. Now, this is an American League team, of course. And they have a pitcher that's a real good batter. Could they
You can only do it for the pitcher.
And let the pitcher bat for himself?
No, you can only do it for the pitcher.
Well,
so, you know,
you're thinking of high school rules, Ken.
Hey, Jacob DeGrom is hitting over 400, Mets ace pitcher. Now he's in the National League and he bats more, but he's hitting over 400. And but no, you can only
pitch. They can't have a designated hitter for anyone except the pitcher, right?
That's correct.
Correct.
But even if the pitcher bats for himself, in other words, it's not a situation where you can have one designated hitter for whoever you choose. That doesn't work, huh?
No.
That's all I had, guys. Thank you.
Okey-doke.
We see that happen at the high school level.
Really? They can do that?
Yeah. See that at the high school level. All right, from the Asher Record Service Company live feedback, Adam says, when does the Hootens Football Preseason Magazine come out, and when will you do the high school football preview with Barry Grooms? I texted Barry last week asking for the schedule. I should have asked him, and I'll do that during the break, Adam, to find out when the magazine is actually going to be released. I usually try to give Barry a couple of weeks for distribution purposes, because they take it throughout the entire state. And up to that point, he does not have the time to come on to the show. All right, Rick Schaefer, Ray Tucker, I'm Randy Rainwater. Drive Time Sports will continue in a moment.
Tune in to From the Shortgrass with me, Trey Schaap, every Friday morning at 5:30 right here on 103.7 The Buzz. From the Shortgrass is sponsored by Blackman Auctions and MinnowsPlus.com.
Are you experiencing fatigue, muscle loss, mood changes, or low sex drive? Hey men, it's time to listen to your body. You don't have to live with these symptoms. Arkansas Urology Men's Health Clinic is helping men live better by providing a free 10-point health checkup. Now is the perfect time to take control of your health. To schedule your screening, visit ArkansasUrology.com.
Little Rock's closest place to play is just 40 minutes away at the Saracen Casino Resort. Join us this month and play to win your share of up to $100,000 in prizes, including an all-new Mustang Mach-E electric vehicle. On Saturday nights this month, Saracen will give away more than $50,000 in free slot play. Join Saracen's Free Players Club and win your share of $100,000, including a chance at a brand-new electric Mustang. Saracen is Vegas, Arkansas style. Gambling problem? Call 800-522-4700.
Over the past few months, you've probably found yourself doing some or all of the following.
Zoom to the bathroom. Zoom to the coffee machine. Zoom meeting at 9. Zoom to let the dog out. Zoom to the fridge. Zoom meeting at 2. Zoom to pick up groceries.
Whoa! Hang on there, not so fast. Just because you're zooming everywhere else doesn't mean you can zoom down the road at excessive speeds. Make slowing down part of your new normal.
A message from the Arkansas State Police Highway Safety Office.
Hello, Mr. Crane. I'm calling about today's appointment. The tree is scheduled to fall on your RV at 2:14 today.
Any way we can reschedule? We're really enjoying our trip.
Oh, I'm sorry, but that's our only opening.
Can it just be a little tree?
Let me check. No, sorry. Our file says it's a huge one.
RV owners can't schedule when things go wrong on the road. That's why there's Progressive, a leader in RV insurance.
Is it 2:14 p.m. or a.m.?
You know, I'm not sure. Can I put you on a brief hold?
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates.
Want to hear something amazing? Discover matches all the cash back you earn on your credit card at the end of your first year, automatically, dollar for dollar, with no limit on how much you can earn. Extra cash? Come on, how amazing is that? In fact, it's even more amazing when you realize all the places where Discover is accepted. 99% of places in the U.S. that take credit cards. So when it comes to Discover, get used to hearing yes more often. Learn more at discover.com/yes. 2021 Nielsen Report. Limitations apply.
It's Justin Acri for my friends at CertaPro Painters, and they have a brand new offering for you to consider. How about getting a professionally applied concrete coating on your floors? It's perfect for garages, patios, and commercial facilities. So whether it's for your home or your business, CertaPro's got you covered with floor coatings. CertaPro has taken care of the exterior and interior of your home for years. Let them take care of your floors as well. And they have a wide selection of color options. Each CertaPro Painters business is independently owned and operated. Schedule your free estimate at CertaPro.com. That's Certa with a C.
Now, back to the Eat My Catfish Studios and Drive Time Sports. Feed your crave today at any of the five Eat My Catfish locations. Conway, Benton, Little Rock, North Little Rock, and now in Fayetteville. Contact them at eatmycatfish.com. The number one sports radio show in Arkansas. Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network.
Drive Time Sports and the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, Ray Tucker. I'm Randy Rainwater. This from our Asher Record Service Company live feed feedback. Mitch says from NWA, here's what I find ironic. What states love SEC football? The red states. What states lag the nation woefully in vaccinated people? The red states. What states are going to have reduced attendance? Right now, none that I'm aware of.
No, none. In fact, they're all expecting full stadiums. So here's what we don't know. And I'm not throwing this out as a trying to be controversial or anything else, but here's what we don't know. Now, I'm for being vaccinated. I'm vaccinated. You two both are vaccinated. We're for that, okay? But here's what we don't know. These stadiums that are full again, if you watch and the Texas Rangers aren't very good, so they filled their stadium for a while. Now they're still having good crowds. I'm looking at the attendance figures at a lot of these Major League Baseball games. They're very good. How would we know if anybody got COVID at a baseball game? And if they did, it seems like it would be headlines if anybody knew about it, because people are just dying to talk about how they shouldn't be having big gatherings again. And yet, I haven't seen anything like that. Look at Mississippi State's baseball. Arkansas was drawing 11,000. They were drawing 15,000 for their regional. But I haven't heard anything about anybody getting COVID in these large gatherings. So I understand the need to be vaccinated and all that, but when it comes to what that guy just said was, you know, yeah, the southern states are the lowest, but do we have any evidence that these gatherings are causing any COVID? I got to believe if there was evidence, they'd be out there. It'd be on the front page of every paper and every website, don't you think?
Well, you go back to the College World Series as not necessarily the classic example.
Yeah.
We know what happened with North Carolina State.
Right. But what about fans? What about fans that were there?
They showed all of the different shots, if you will, of the crowd that was in attendance, and not once did they ever say, well, or the next day, well, we have four or five cases developed from, you know, outside of the crowds that were in attendance the night before.
Right.
I never heard a word about that.
23,000. So, yeah. Was it terrible what happened to NC State? Absolutely. But are we seeing – I haven't seen a Major League Baseball player test positive for COVID in months, if at all, this season, have they?
I hadn't heard about any, no.
And they are playing in front of larger crowds. So I think it's a little unfair to say because – And again, I'm an advocate for being vaccinated. I want to say that right up front. I'm an advocate for getting vaccinated. But I don't think we've seen evidence of these crowds where we don't know who's vaccinated, who doesn't, who's not. So we haven't seen evidence of COVID spreading from there.
I mean, if you go back to when it all started and spring break and they talked about the outbreaks following that, all these big groups got together. And now you have baseball games, College World Series. All that. They run numbers, believe me, they do. And
yeah.
you haven't seen anything about big outbreak from the College World Series.
No, yeah. And they had 23,000 for all those games. So, that's a lot. So,
yeah.
I'm no scientist. I'm not trying to speculate. I'm not trying to raise questions on either side of this. I'm just saying that as of right now. And I know in Arkansas today, there were more new cases than there's ever been since February. And I don't have any explanation for that, and I wish that weren't the case. And I hope that will lead to people that aren't vaccinated to get vaccinated. But nonetheless, I think at Razorback Stadium on September 4th, there are going to be as many people that buy tickets are going to be there. And I think the following week against Texas, we'd all be shocked if that's not 74,000 people.
I have not heard any venues as of late that's going to be restricted in the fall. I know ULR, Little Rock, put out a release a couple weeks ago saying they were going back to full capacity.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, Arkansas did the same thing maybe 3-4 weeks ago, whatever it was.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody's playing on full capacity. So, I have heard nothing except they will be asking if you haven't been vaccinated to please wear a mask. Well, how can you social distance if you are unvaccinated and you're part of that crowd, even if you're wearing a mask? How can you social distance? You can't. You could, in some regards, for the Rice game, but I'm with you, Rick. I think that the Texas game is going to be a sellout. I'd be very shocked if it's not a sellout.
You know, I was talking to some folks last night, and some of them said, oh, I don't think it'll be a sellout. And I said, well, you're a little younger than I am. I know what the past history is with Arkansas and Texas and the Southwest Conference. I expect it to be a sellout. I understand it's a 6 o'clock game, and it's on national television. I understand that. That should encourage people to even more so to be there.
I would just simply be shocked, Raymond, if it's not a sellout. But that's me. All right, let's check in with Big Country real quick. Big Country, good afternoon.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Doing great. Good. Thank you, Big Country.
I've had my COVID shot also. And I think if everybody wants everything to get to normal, you know, whether they believe in it or not, if you want college football, go ahead and get the shot. You know, what have you done? You haven't gotten a shot. You haven't tried to keep that normal, have you?
Well, I was going into the grocery store last night, and it had on the outside of the store free COVID-19 mm-hmm. vaccinations. Free, F-R-E-E. Oh, yeah. So there shouldn't be a reason why, if it's free, you can't use the excuse, I can't afford it.
That's right.
Yeah, you know, it's sort of like if we do have a relapse and attendance gets dropped, and they're looking at ratings of, you know, which state, you know, if you have 50% of your population is vaccinated, then you can only have this many. You know, the people that don't get vaccinated, they have nothing to complain about if they cause us not to be able to go to games. It'd be like complaining who got voted for president, but you never did put your ballot in.
Very true.
You know, what did you do to help change it? What did you do to keep progress going? Mm-hmm. You really didn't do nothing. You just complained, and you didn't get that free shot. And everybody loves free stuff. I don't understand why you don't get that shot.
Well, there are various reasons, and there are people, and when we don't want to get into a big discussion on that on the program, but there are people that have definite reasons they don't, and I'm not about to get on the air and argue with them either. I'm just saying that if there are issues with large gatherings, not knowing who has been vaccinated, who hasn't, we have not seen any COVID outbreaks from these large gatherings. So
right.
That's
yeah, I agree, but that doesn't mean that it couldn't happen.
It could, sure. All things you are know, possible. Yeah.
If we don't learn from what they say about history in school, if we don't learn about history, will it repeat itself?
It seems to.
Yeah, I actually had a guy to try to tell me that the shot that they put a bug in you, and he wanted to put a magnet to my arm. I said, I'm not listening to that nonsense. They're not bugging us.
That same guy just got back from Mars, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah. He said, I put it up to a person's arm, and it stuck to him. Man, I don't believe that. I believe that one bit. But, you know, I'm for the vaccination. But, you know, we can't have a relapse. So, everybody, you know, I'm glad it's back to normal. We can go to games, but it could relapse, and the people that didn't get that free shot, they can't complain if it happens.
All right, Big Country, thank you. All right, Rick Schaefer, Ray Tucker, I'm Randy Rainwater. Drive Time Sports will continue in a moment.
Hi, folks. Mike Linton with Heritage Agriculture. Wow, what a year 2020 has been. Let's hope and pray 2021 will be better. What better way to kick off the year with a